My God.
Ah.
Wow.
Whoa.
Well, that is insane.
The weight of this is just such a game changer.
It's comfortable.
Yep. 100 grams is a deal. This is a big deal.
Wow, it's super sleek already.
This side and no cable.
Yeah.
I mean, that's freedom.
Meta has finally beaten Apple. That's right. Meta just dropped the Orion AR glasses, and let me tell you, these might just be the most advanced glasses the world has ever seen. We are talking about a 70-degree field of view, full eye-tracking cameras, speakers, microphones, Wi-Fi 6, and even a wrist-worn neural interface. These glasses are definitely the future of technology. But of course, all anyone seems to care about is one thing. Are these Orion AR glasses better than Apple's Vision Pro? How is Apple going to top this? Let's find out. A look at Orion. Now that Meta has finally released its Orion AR glasses, our expectations are through the roof. Let's have a look at them. The Orion AR glasses come equipped with a 70-degree field of view. Now, if you have used AR or VR before, you know that the field of view is a big deal. It basically determines how much of the world around you is being blended with the digital stuff. A lot of AR glasses have a pretty limited field of view, but with Orion, Meta has really pushed the boundaries. That extra visual space makes a world of difference. This field of view feels more immersive, like the digital elements are actually part of your environment instead of awkwardly floating in front of you. On top of that, Meta has packed these glasses with a ton of technology. There are full eye-tracking cameras, which are kind of a game-changer. With this kind of precision tracking, the glasses know exactly where you are looking, making interactions feel smooth and natural. Whether you are navigating through an app or just admiring the digital overlays, it all happens seamlessly. No more awkwardly tapping or swiping to make things happen. Just look and let the glasses do the work. It is almost like they are reading your mind. Almost. But that's not all. There are also outer cameras tucked along the edges of the frame. These cameras handle room and hand tracking, meaning the glasses can detect where you are in the world and how you are moving your hands, giving you a much more interactive experience. Pair that with the speakers and microphones built into the glasses, and you are essentially wearing a mini AR setup on your face. It is the kind of technology we have only dreamed about until now. Now, one of the cooler parts of Orion is its wireless design. You won't be tethered to some bulky device. There is a small processor puck that handles all the heavy lifting. It is similar to Apple's Vision Pro battery pack, but smaller and lighter, making the whole setup feel less clunky. And the best part is that it all runs wirelessly, which means you get full mobility without being attached to a cable. That's a major win for anyone who is tired of feeling like they are tied down when using tech like this. The glasses themselves weigh only 100 grams, which is pretty impressive considering how much tech is crammed into them. They have a sleek, albeit thick design that might not scream everyday wear, but they are not that far off either. Honestly, they look kind of cool in a futuristic way, like something you would expect to see in a sci-fi movie. And they are comfortable enough that you can wear them for a decent amount of time without feeling like they are weighing you down. So why is this a big deal? Well, for one, it is clear that Meta is serious about pushing AR into mainstream use. These glasses are a significant leap forward in making AR more accessible and, dare I say, cooler. And while they are still in the prototype phase, with a lot of refinement ahead before they hit the market, it is exciting to see where this is all heading. Before we see if these new AR glasses are really better than Apple's Vision Pro, let's have a look at their display technology. Display technology. You see, the Orion glasses use silicon carbide lenses, which is a big deal in the AR world. Silicon carbide is an advanced material known for its toughness, lightweight nature, and ability to conduct heat efficiently. In the context of AR glasses, this material allows for high-performance visuals without adding extra bulk or overheating, which is crucial when you are wearing these glasses for long periods. Now these lenses work with micro-LED projectors. Micro-LEDs are tiny, but they are great when it comes to brightness and efficiency. Compared to traditional LEDs, micro-LEDs can produce much sharper images with higher contrast and better color accuracy. This matters because in AR, You want the digital elements to blend seamlessly with the real world. The clearer and more vibrant the visuals are, the more immersive your experience will be. You won't have to deal with dull or washed-out visuals, which is a common complaint with lower-end AR systems. What's really cool is how these micro-LEDs project images onto the lenses using something called diffractive waveguides. Waveguides are essentially a way to direct light across the surface of the lenses so that the image stays crisp and clear, no matter where you are looking. The light gets bent and spread across the lenses in such a way that it hits your eyes just right. This is important because it keeps the visuals sharp and helps avoid what's known as the rainbow effect, where colors can appear distorted at certain angles. Meta has managed to give Orion a 70-degree field of view, which is wider than most AR headsets out there. We have already seen what it means for you. You will not be limited to seeing just a small section of your environment mixed with digital content. Instead, you will get a much broader, more natural experience where the AR visuals seem to wrap around you, almost as if they are part of your world rather than floating in a small box in front of your face. The display resolution is currently set at 13 pixels per degree, which is not as sharp as Meta's Quest 3 VR headset, but still good enough for most AR experiences. Meta is working on boosting this resolution to 26 pixels per degree in the future, which would bring even clearer, more detailed visuals to the table. This resolution bump is necessary, especially when you consider that the wider field of view requires more pixels to maintain image quality across a larger area. And then they introduced the best quality they could ever include in their glasses. What is this new addition? Neural wristband. It is the neural wristband that comes with Meta's Orion AR glasses, which is one of the most exciting pieces of technology in this whole setup. This is not just some ordinary accessory, it is a game changer for how we interact with augmented reality. So what exactly is the neural wristband, and why did Meta include it? Let's have a look. The neural wristband is designed to be worn on your wrist, just like a fitness tracker. But it has much more advanced tech under the hood. The key to this wristband is something called electromyography technology. EMG works by detecting the electrical signals your muscles generate when they move. Essentially, whenever you move your hand or fingers, your brain sends electrical signals through your nerves to your muscles, telling them to move. The wristband picks up on these signals and translates them into actions that the AR glasses can understand. In simple terms, the wristband reads your muscle movements and turns them into digital commands. For example, if you pinch your thumb and forefinger together, the wristband can recognize that motion and use it to select an option on your AR interface. The coolest part is that this wristband is so sensitive that it can even pick up on tiny, subtle movements. Movements so small that you don't even have to physically move your hand. That's right. Just thinking about a gesture can be enough for the wristband to detect it and translate it into a digital action. Why did Meta include this wristband? Well, traditional AR glasses rely on either hand-tracking cameras or touchpad interfaces to interact with the digital world. While these methods work, they can feel clunky and limiting. Hand-tracking cameras, for example, need to have a clear view of your hands, which can be tricky depending on your environment or what you are doing. If you are in a space where your hands are outside the camera's view, or you are in a crowded area, hand-tracking can easily fail. The neural wristband solves these problems by providing a much more reliable and intuitive way to control your AR experience. You don't need to keep your hands in front of the cameras, and you don't need to touch anything physically. Instead, the wristband allows you to control the glasses with gestures, even when your hands are down by your sides or in your pockets. This level of freedom is a big step forward in making AR feel more natural and effortless. But the benefits don't stop there. The wristband also allows for more precise interactions. With traditional hand tracking or touch interfaces, there is always a bit of lag or inaccuracy. You might miss a selection or trigger the wrong command. EMG technology, on the other hand, provides much faster and more accurate input because it is directly reading your muscle signals. This means you can interact with your AR environment in real time with minimal delay. Another great benefit of the wristband is that it takes some of the processing load off the AR glasses themselves. The glasses are already handling a lot, like tracking your eyes, displaying graphics, and processing the environment around you. By shifting some of the input tasks to the wristband, Meta can reduce the strain on the glasses, making the whole system more efficient. On top of that, the wristband has its own built-in battery and processor, so it does not drain power from the glasses. In terms of user experience, the wristband also makes multitasking in AR a breeze. Let's say you are walking down the street, you can glance at a notification in your AR display and casually swipe it away with a small thumb gesture without even lifting your hand. Or say you are in the middle of a meeting and need to quickly pull up some information without drawing attention, just a flick of your thumb can bring up a virtual document without any fuss. This level of subtle control is what makes the neural wristband so amazing. In the bigger picture, the neural wristband is laying the groundwork for the future of AR and wearable tech. By incorporating neural input, Meta is pushing AR closer to a future where we would blur the line between the digital and physical world. Instead of needing to rely on clunky controllers or gestures that feel unnatural, we are moving towards a future where our thoughts and intentions can seamlessly control our digital interactions. AI integration. Another thing that makes Orion AR glasses the most advanced glasses in the world is their AI integration. One demo lets you use voice commands to generate images or ask for recipes based on ingredients on a table. The AI recognizes objects in real time, providing interactive feedback through pop-up icons. But the AI is not limited to just cooking. It can help you manage your daily schedule, set reminders, or even control smart home devices. You would be able to ask your glasses to dim the lights or adjust the thermostat while you are in the middle of another task. The level of convenience this brings is undeniable, but it also means AR is starting to blend seamlessly into everyday life. You are no longer tied to a screen or device. The AI is accessible wherever you are, making the Orion glasses feel like an extension of your own capabilities. And now the biggest question, are Meta's Orion AR glasses really better than Vision Pro? Apple vs. Meta. When comparing Meta's Orion AR glasses to Apple's Vision Pro, it is clear that both companies are aiming for the top spot in the augmented reality space. However, while both devices bring impressive technology to the table, there are distinct differences in design, functionality, and overall user experience that set them apart. Let's weigh the pros and cons of each before we settle on which is better. Starting with Meta's Orion AR glasses, one of their most significant advantages is their sleek and relatively lightweight design. Weighing in at just 100 grams, these glasses feel much less bulky compared to the Vision Pro, which comes in at a heavy 600 grams. That difference in weight is a big deal when you are thinking about wearing these devices for extended periods. Meta's focus on making the Orion glasses slim and comfortable to wear is a huge win, especially when you consider how much technology is packed into them. Another area where Meta shines is the wireless design of the Orion glasses. Meta has created a completely untethered experience with a small portable processor puck that powers the glasses. This puck is not only lighter than Vision Pro's battery pack, but it also allows you to enjoy a full AR experience without being physically attached to a device. The freedom to move around without cords or bulky batteries makes the Orion glasses feel more seamless and natural in everyday settings. On the other hand, Apple's Vision Pro, while technologically advanced, comes with big trade-offs. One of the biggest complaints is the device's weight and bulk. The Vision Pro is physically larger and heavier, and its battery pack is tethered by a cord that can make it feel restrictive during use. Sure, Apple packs an incredible display quality and processing power, but the size and weight make it less appealing for long-term use. After all, nobody wants to feel like they are wearing a helmet just to experience augmented reality. When it comes to price, the Vision Pro really starts to lose ground. Apple has positioned the Vision Pro as a high-end luxury device with a starting price of around $3,500. For most consumers, that's a huge investment for a device that still feels somewhat experimental. Meanwhile, Meta is aiming for a price closer to $1,000 for the Orion glasses, which, while still expensive, are much more accessible. They say that each pair is costing them $10,000, but they are trying to lower that price to $1,000. This lower price point opens the door for a broader range of users, making AR a more realistic part of everyday life, rather than a luxury reserved for those who can afford to splurge on Apple's premium technology. At the end of the day, while the Vision Pro might have the flash of Apple's brand and an impressive display, it falls short in some key areas. The sheer weight and bulk of the device make it impractical for everyday use, especially if you are hoping to wear it for extended periods. Combine that with the steep price tag, and it becomes clear that Apple is targeting a niche market rather than trying to make AR mainstream. But do you really need to buy a pair of AR glasses? Do you need them? Well, let's put it this way. Remember when people used to ask, "Do you really need a smartphone?" Yeah, we all know how that turned out. Look around you now. Can you even imagine a world without them? Smartphones have become an extension of ourselves, practically glued to our hands 24/7. And when we look around today, we are standing on the edge of the next big leap, augmented reality. So yes, you do need AR glasses, and here's why. First off, the world is moving fast, and technology is at the heart of everything we do. What was cutting edge yesterday is already outdated today. AR glasses like Meta's Orion are not just another gadget, they represent the future of how we interact with the world around us. Think about it. Just like smartphones changed how we communicate, access information, and live our lives, imagine this. Instead of checking your phone every 5 minutes for directions, notifications, or messages, all that info is projected right in front of your eyes. Need to check your calendar while you are walking? Done. Want to pull up a recipe while cooking? Easy. With AR, the digital world merges with your everyday life, making everything more convenient and hands-free. And that's just the beginning. In the future, think about gaming and entertainment, having virtual worlds overlay your real one, fully immersing you without needing to be tethered to a device. Or imagine collaborating on work projects in real time, where digital models and data pop up in front of you, making remote work feel more connected than ever. AR will also revolutionize education and training. Instead of reading about complex subjects in a book, you could visualize them in 3D right in front of you, making learning far more engaging and interactive. On top of all that, engineering, and even tourism. Surgeons could overlay critical information during operations, engineers could visualize complex blueprints in real time, and travelers could explore cities with historical context appearing right before their eyes. The possibilities are endless. Let's not forget the convenience factor. We live in a world where multitasking is a must, and AR glasses let you handle everything hands-free. Whether you are jogging, cooking, or even just out for a walk, you can access information and stay connected without missing a beat. So, do you need Meta's Orion AR glasses? The answer is a big, resounding yes. They are the future of technology. And just like how we cannot imagine life without our smartphones, in a few years, we will all be asking, how did we ever live without AR glasses? So, are you going to buy them? Let us know in the comments below. If you want more updates on amazing technologies, go ahead and subscribe to the channel because we have got a lot more of this. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.